I would like to show you the equation. For example, I'm going to choose FT, the solve an equation like this. So 4 minus, we press alpha, and then we get the any of these letters. For example, I can put U, V, W, I'm going to put X. Just gonna do the equal sign, it's in there, and just press shift, and then yeah, 3. So we want to find the X. All we do, and press solve, and it's thinking sometimes if it's difficult. There it is, in fractions. All you do, just press this button, fraction and decimal button. And it just shows you decimal fraction. It also works with thirds. For example, you want to calculate between 2/3 or 2 plus, let's go for the easy one, 2 plus 2 in it. You want to see this in decimal as well. All you do is just press the button and it shows you in decimal x squared graph. We just press draw here, and it's just gonna show us the x2 graph. You can actually register memory. For example, you want formulas, check out the formulas. You can also put any formulas, as much formula as you like. And press X here. So that's the activity application. Yeah, style sheet. And this is like a mini Excel sheet. I just typed in some numbers here. This is current versus voltage. And I'm going to see the graph of this, and we can go as much as you like, as many columns as we like. It's just like in Excel, and all we do is just say here we have graph 1, graph 2, graph 3. Different view for the same numbers, and all you do is just press set here, and you can change the view of the graph. And there's a lot of things in here. You can also install your own application. You can program here. I haven't checked everything out. We see the memory here. There is this two options here, the menu option. And if you press setup, and if you say linear, it's 2.5 times 2.5, just this. I'm gonna for the mathematical. In here, you can have very complicated display. If I change this like 4, it's gonna change whatever I followed it through from. So it did change the answer. There it is, different answer now. So one more feature to look at is many characters. How, what can you input in? All you do is just this insert button here. These are the characters you can input. Press mat. All the symbols. Omega, all the Greek signs. Is this button, which is you can just do fraction. And press draw on these buttons, and you can sketch, you can change the window, standard window, trigonometric window, or I'm going to change the zoom. You want it to be closer, just go there and press execute. Yeah. You can also trace. See every point there, you can see. Another interesting program is this one. Conversions. Statics application. The dynamic graph, recursion, you can install more applications here as long as it has a memory. The equation feature even allows us to solve an equation like this. E to the power 2x, there's an X button is located here and equals to zero. If you press solve button and it just solved it for us. So the X would be this number. Just say draft. Here it is. Okay, let's see the processing power of this. This is a population growth curve. Let's draw this. You can change the window. That's it. I paragraph looks more realistic now. We can solve the maximum value. Let me show you a way. Here it is, polynomial. This is a 2-degree. So all we need to do, b is 11 and c is 12. So just press solve. There it is. This is here is the minimum value. There is up to 6-degree polynomial. This formula here, there's no formula for 6-degree polynomial, but you can do it on this calculator.